Hey, so I want to start from the top. We're going to be looking at VOO. And if you're unfamiliar, VOO is the top 500 stocks in the New York Stock Exchange. So this kind of gives us a broad sense of what's happening out there. And it kind of trickles down into all the other stocks. And that's why it's the number one stock that we like to start with as we work our way down. Right off the bat, this is just like a summary of where we were last time we looked at them. So it wasn't too long ago, about 2 weeks since the last time we looked. What we're gonna do is more or less just technical analysis on this one. I'll add any insights I can. If you have any questions, by all means, let me know. Or if you want to add insights from your end, by all means, I'm open to that. I checked, there wasn't really any news around this one, at least from the source that I use. So we will just be able to go right into technicals and then we'll close it out. So again, last time we looked at this was May 29th, so about 2 weeks ago. At that point, number one, we marked it red, so it was at resistance, or we didn't feel like it was a good buy at that point. But it was trading at 385. We had buy points marked at 349 and 360, also noting resistance at 388 and 407, hence why we marked it red. It was near resistance. We also noted that it broke out, or a breakout occurred towards the end of April, and also it was in this uptrend for the last 1.5 months. I also added this ETF concentration. So we have VOO here. These are the top 10 holdings in the stock. The only changes that I noticed is that in the top 10, last time we looked, Tesla was there at about 1.62%. They have fallen off their top 10. It's no longer there. And now all of a sudden, United Health Group is in there. So that might give us a hint that the healthcare market or healthcare sector might be improving versus consumer discretionary is going down currently. So just something to keep in mind there. But otherwise, everything is more or less the same. You can see some of the percentages have kind of, been updated a little bit, but for the most part, they're all within reason, so nothing surprising outside of those two that I mentioned earlier. So let's go into the technical, see what we see. So again, we see this breakout that we were referring to, 429. Let me just make this a little bigger for us. So breakout occurred on 429. That was, I guess here, I must have been referring to this. I think I was referring to it exceeding the 375 mark, and then ultimately it's now nearing resistance here because now we're pushing to 403. So it was at 385. And here's where we last looked, right in here, somewhere in the middle. I guess for this bar specifically, it was closer to the bottom. 529? Interesting. So we were in like this tail piece. If you could, it's really faint, but we were in this tail, and since then, it's just gone up. It continues to go up. So, if you saw something different than me, you would have made out on this one. This one's clearly breaking out, and it's sticking to that. I just want to zoom out here. Number one, I'm going to remove this yellow sideways consolidation marking. That was drawn in because we noticed this pattern where it was consolidating between 350, 375, and right here we had an inflection point, and that was where we were projecting. Is it going to go down or is it going to continue up? Clearly it continued up, and so I don't really feel there's a need for this one anymore, so that can go. This purple trend, what I want to do is I want to modify that to go from here And I just want to see if we were to use something like this instead, where we break this out somewhere like that, and if we do the same to here, and we make this more or less parallel. Let me zoom out a little bit more. That looks pretty good. So I hope, number one, you're seeing that this is very flexible, and it all depends on just what you're seeing. And I didn't like how it was going well above that. And I also noticed, just if we look back, I think we were putting a lot of weight on this sideways consolidation from about November till March. So there was like a 4 to 5 month period where it was trading sideways, and we even saw back here a little more of that with a couple peaks above and below. But we're putting a lot of weight behind that, and I guess rightfully so, especially if we stretch it back nearly a full year. It was in that range for probably like 80 to 90%. But then, now that it's breaking out above 375, closing in on 407, which is a more highly anticipated resistance point. I don't know. I'm just seeing, we had a bottom here, and we could say here's the third bottom in this series. Two of the three are kind of in line, if that makes sense. And this one is like, it just broke out of that channel, but that's nothing surprising because, again, here's a period where it was above that. So with this kind of updated view or vantage point, one can argue that this is kind of at the bottom of the channel, which would mean maybe now is a decent spot. The thing is, for me, whenever I look back in the past, and again, we're pretty soon, probably in the next like year or two, a lot of these are going to just keep trending upwards and reach all-time highs for a lot of the stocks we follow. And that's when we're really going to have to stay on top of things because, we'll be in new territory. We won't be able to rely on the past as much as we have for this year and probably last year to some extent. So just something to keep in mind for everybody. But for right now, I do think there's going to be a little bit of trouble here at 407, and considering we're at 401, again, I'm feeling like there's just going to be better opportunities out there. And I think even just looking back at the past year, we saw the Russell 2000 was at a decent buy point. We also noted healthcare was at a decent buy point. We'll see how these others fluctuate a lot in that fair value range. Just VOO, it seems to be at the top or nearing the top. And as we've seen with others, when something like this happens, it can definitely continue this breakout trend and potentially grow another 10% above its previous high, all-time high, that is, up to like 20 or 30%. These are all possible scenarios that could take place. It's just in the short term, I'm just feeling like this one's going to hit 407, probably get rejected. Maybe not long term though. Maybe it'll just kind of hit it, bounce back, and then all of a sudden that's when we're going to get this push above by an extra, say, $20, $30. These are all possible scenarios. So I guess at this point, it's really just how much weight do we want to put behind our different markings here? And I'm wondering why this one's. I use a different green here for some reason, but that's something else. So what I mean is, clearly we have this uptrend. This uptrend's been intact since October. We're at the bottom of it for the most part, probably halfway actually, compared to where it is right now. So if we think that uptrend is the dominant trend, and that trend's going to continue for, I don't know, the foreseeable future, again, because we don't really have news to back this up, other than the fact that, I mean, using our own research, if we look at all the different sectors, and I realize this isn't all of them, I think there's supposed to be 11. We're currently tracking eight of them. So, but whenever we look at the eight that we are tracking, they pretty much all balance out to a fair value right now. None of them are at a buy, so no dips. None of them are really overpriced outside of technology, which received that ranking. So overall, I guess I would say this is fair. It's fair. To me, it seems overpriced because, even if we give the majority position to this uptrend, say 60%, I believe 60% that this uptrend is going to continue forward. We'll just say for the next year, there's still that 40% that I'm giving to our horizontal trend, our consolidation ranges, where in the past, going back to about third quarter 2021, we saw resistance at 407. We're very near 407. So there's a 40% chance, and I just made those numbers up. I mean, maybe if I thought about this a little more, maybe it'd be like 30%. Either way, there's some noticeable portion that I would say it's going to hit its head at 407 and get rejected. And maybe if that does happen, considering where it is on the uptrend, maybe I would consider buying it if it, like, say, had a dip below here, below trend, pulled back to a range like, maybe to like 375. I would consider it. There seems to be some sort of support there in 2021. It kind of acted as support here in 22, and then most recently in like April, it broke above 375, wanted to pull back, but the market was like, no, 375 is an okay figure for this. So what I'll do, I'm gonna keep this one as red for right now, but my idea of this stock is starting to turn a little bit. And I hope I explained why it's kind of changing. But so just to update the tracker, so it went from 385, today it's at 401. For me to buy this one, originally we had 349 and 360 marked. What I'm gonna do is put in another one at 375. I'm gonna make 375 the bold figure here, meaning that's the first one that I'll actually consider buying. Resistance at 388. There really wasn't much there, so I'm actually gonna just delete that line. I'm gonna remove it from our tracker. I will keep 407 because there's two, technically 3 points of interest at 407. So I think it might stall out there for maybe a week or two, but this uptrend could continue on. I would buy that news. Update the date. In terms of our note, a breakout occurred on 429. Yeah, that's kind of par for the course here. But I'm gonna update it from in an uptrend since October. Uptrend in an uptrend since October 2022. Okay, so that pretty much wraps this one up. Of course, let me know what your thoughts are, but just to get a quick summary of what our final idea of this one is right now. So we have VOO here. Now it's been updated. Currently it's at 401. We have buy points marked at 349, 360, and 375. If this one pulled back to 375 in the next, say, week or two, or over the next month, yeah, I'd probably pick this one up at that point. If it dropped lower, I'd be more so waiting for, say, 360 or 350, and then maybe adding on another share. Resistance, I think 407 might be a little bit of trouble. Not too much considering the pace it's on, but still it might, like I said, stall out there for a couple weeks and then continue upwards. Of course, the date and then our note, we still are going to keep that breakout, which occurred at the end of April, but we also updated it's in an uptrend and it's been that way since October 2022. So that pretty much wraps this up. If you enjoyed this, please like, subscribe, and of course, if you have any questions or want to add any insight of your own, feel free to comment below. But that's it. So I'll see you on the next one. Bye.